ready to match the stars. Jimmy Walker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. Now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you. Thank you, Johnny Olsen. Can you say my name? I didn't hear you say my name. I didn't know when to come out.
I didn't hear it either.
Now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn!
Yeah! Say it. Well, thank you, one and all. We welcome all of you, and you, and you, and you, and you.
And you.
Nice to see all of you again. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. You know, he didn't say your name. He said Peter Marshall.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Just for that, I'm not going to say City of Angels.
You were not.
I'm not going to say that ever again. Ever. And
yes,
good time.
Yes, himself is here.
There, Jimmy J.J. Walker. All right, shall we begin without any... Yes.
Before we... You drop this, sweetheart.
Oh, Felky! Oh,
Felky! Boy, has that been around.
You can't see it, but it does say Encino.
Encino Motel.
Encino Motel. By fucking me.
You rascal. How about saying hello to Darlene Landon and Pete Brizzo over here? Hey. This lady is a big money winner. She won $11,550, right?
Right.
Right. And right. As you can see, she's won so much money, she's dyed it all the way down to there now. No, she's a natural lady. And she's a music major, and she writes songs, and she's got a great smile, and she's being challenged by Pete here. You had your first round question, didn't you?
Yes.
And you found out that the first round questions are rather difficult, aren't they?
Yes.
And she's going to find that out in a moment or so. But right now, we want to find out about this message for you. Thank you. Here we go. In the middle of round one. Darlene, this is all yours. It's your first rounder. Listen carefully, because it's a toughie.
All right.
The manager of Consumer Reports said, last Wednesday, everybody showed up for work because that was the day we tested blank.
I don't even understand that question.
This is a perfectly marvelous question. Now listen to it again. The manager of Consumer Reports said, last Wednesday, everybody showed up for work because that was the day we tested blank.
No! What a dummy I was not to get that.
No peeking.
Okay, no peeking down. Everybody ready
there. Actually, it is a good question.
It's a marvelous question.
It's just that it clashes with all our others. That's why it took us a minute.
All right. I want to thank you for rearranging the set just a little bit. Just those 8 inches you moved this downstage really has helped a great deal. But a little, I'm just wasting time here while the retardees finish their answer up on the upper tier.
It's true. Come on, you guys.
Oh, there
Jimmy, you guys.
Yes. You're slowing down. Yes.
She's gone crazy now that she's
You look
pregnant.
Different, JJ. What is different about you?
Well, I've been working, and I have a little more cash now.
Oh, I see. It does show, doesn't it? All right, Darlene, the manager of Consumer Reports said, last Wednesday, everybody showed up for work because that was the day we tested blank.
Oh, my dear. We tested,
What would make everybody show up for work? That's what the whole idea.
New birth control methods.
What's that? New birth control methods, eh? Sit down there. Sit down there.
I might add, Elaine didn't show up that day.
Elaine didn't show up that day?
But I showed up the day after.
You're letting the cat out of the bag there. What do you say?
Well, you'll be down the day after that because you'll be free to go down. I said girls or women.
Girls or women?
Yes!
That was the day we tested girls or women.
Women, yeah, just that's a finance. I would have been there.
That's a...
personal answer. I hate personal answers.
Male chauvinist pig.
You have to be objective on this show.
Right, what do you got?
And you have to give an objective answer. I said they chose scotch, rye, vodka, gin, and or other liquors.
What else? That's the way her mind works, Charles.
Mine works that way, too. Only one card was necessary.
Liquor in bottles. Liquor in bottles. That's the way you said it. Okay. Now, last Wednesday, everybody showed up for Wickers. That was the day we tested new birth control methods, according to Darlene. What did you say?
Well, I said something similar. I said sex.
Sex. No match there.
But they liked it.
Yeah, they do. Well, naturally.
Ways of doing it.
They're not going to boo sex, are they? What do you say to that?
Well, I'm going to appeal to the judges. Now, what was Darlene's answer? I know what the question was.
All right. Everybody Darlene showed up. New birth control methods was her response.
Right. And how do they do that? By making love.
By making love. But that...
Making love. Just a second.
No, wait a minute.
How else can you test those birth control methods?
Well, now, give me an answer.
That's right, you got two. You can, I guess.
One does not necessarily have anything to do with the other. Okay. Now.
I think you ought to clear that up.
No, I don't think we should.
Hello, it's not Fannie. Nice to fool Mother Nature.
What have you got?
I just said booze.
Booze. Yeah. So there we are at the end of round one.
It's close.
And now we'll see what happens with round two. As Jimmy says, it is close. Zip to zip over here. Okay, Pete, it's up to you. A or B?
I'll stay with B.
Stay with B for Britza, he says. Harvey's pants were so tight... he had to wear his blank on the outside. Harvey's pants are so tight he had to wear his blank on the outside.
His blank.
His blank on the outside. Okay, good. Very good there. Good. You got it? Oh. Okay. Everybody ready? Hello, Pete. Pete. Harvey's pants were so tight, he had to wear his blank on the outside.
His shorts.
His shorts, very good. Jimmy, Pete gave a perfectly excellent answer.
That's why he came to me for a perfectly answering match.
Underwear or shorts. Okay, Pete, you got one. Brett?
Would I let you down, Pete? I said his Fruit of the Looms.
Fruit of the Looms. Yes, Charles.
I'm sorry, I said shirt.
His shirt. His head wore a shirt. His pants were so tight he had... Oh, I see what you mean, yes. He couldn't get around the waist. All right, now, Elaine Joyce,
yeah,
what do you
if
say?
You don't, now, if you just don't think quickly, you just kind of glance at this, it could be a little humorous.
Really?
This is terrible. I'm
really?
Glad Charles said shirt, because I said he just couldn't fit his bottom in.
Well, his bottom on the outside,
see,
yes.
See, it's just a quickie. Now, yes. Don't think about it anymore.
Okay, we won't. We might even call on you the rest of the show.
I was going to say something else. Do you want to hear?
No, I don't want to hear what you were saying. What do you say there, Richard?
No, it was singular, not plural.
Harvey's pants were so tight he had to wear his blank on the outside. Well, shorts is...
Well, but you said singular, blank, so I said his shorts.
His short. Oh, yeah.
That will be correct.
What's so funny about that?
Had enough nothing trouble with the that. Making
all
love
right,
birth
I'm,
control.
Yes, now, Fannie, what do you say? There?
I said undershorts.
Undershorts. Okay, you're going to have to go to work when we get back here. Okay, Darlene, we'll come back to Darlene in a moment or so, but right now we want to go to you with this. Here we are. All right. Second and final round, Darlene. Now, you know what you have to do. You've got to match four to tie, five to win. And everyone plays.
Oh. Yaha!
And he just got up, honey. Yeah. Think what it's going to be later on.
You are a weirdo.
Claire the Clown uses three rubber noses. She wears one on her nose and two on her blanks. Clara the Clown.
Clara the Clown.
Right.
We'll discuss this later.
You're so clean-shaven today, you look wonderful.
No, I'm tired, and we'll discuss it later.
Clara the Clown uses three rubber noses. She wears one on her nose and two on her blanks.
How have you been, my dear?
Very well. How have you been?
Very well, thank you. All right, everybody ready down here? Do not, Terry. No artwork, please. Just
I'm
a
not doing
simple
any
response
artwork.
Is all we need there. Now, Darlene, Clara the Clown uses three rubber noses. She wears one on her nose and two on her blanks.
On her boobs.
On her boobs. That would look rather strange, wouldn't it? Jimmy, what do you say to that?
We were dealing with plurals there, weren't we?
Yes, we were indeed. I said blanks.
Blanks. So that means she said what? Boob?
I said boobs.
Boobies.
Boobies. 1 for Darlene. Scores 4-1. Brett?
If I recollect, Clara the Clown was actually a male. Done up in a lot of funny red hair, right?
That's true.
That's true. I said she wore he or he wore it on his little knees. Don't you attack me. I'm an heiress. I don't need this job.
Clara the Clown and Howdy Doody was indeed a
male.
However, with the name Clara, we referred to her as her, you see.
I've spent a lot of many a lovely day watching Howdy Doody and Clara the Clown. I had a nice time, too.
Tell us
about it. Did they show that in the hospital, Andy? Boobs.
Boobs. 4-2 to score. You need two more to tie, Darlene. Three more to win. Let's see what happens here. Elaine, Claire the Clown, uses three rubber noses, one on her nose and two on her blanks.
That's all I could think of.
That's all I could think of? What? Boobs. So now scores 4-3. One more. Well, two more, really, and it'll be a tie. What do you say?
What do you mean?
Another pair is what I mean.
Ah.
They do come in pairs, don't they?
Mine do.
Yeah. Five score. Now, Fannie, it's entirely up to you. This moment we have a tie, and if she matches you, she wins the game. That'll be her fourth winning game.
Something for my friends in the armed forces.
Pete. We've got gifts for Pete Brizza together with our best wishes for being here at Match Game 76. Thank you, Pete. We're standing off. We'll send some messages just for you. Here we are with Darlene for the fourth time. She's got $11,650, and she's going to try for over $5,000 now. You're really going here like gangbusters, my dear.
Yes, I know. It's wonderful.
I think it's wonderful. Do you think it's wonderful? What are you going to do with all that money now? You said you were going to give your mother a vacation. Now, you've got more than enough for that. What else can you do with that?
I really can't think right now. I'd love to tell you a wonderful answer, but I can't think.
Well, you get your ESP going with an audience we had here some time ago, and we got their best response to this. Rat blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 if you hook up with the middle one, and $100 for matching the bottom one. And three celebrities of the six are permitted to assist you in suggesting answers.
Richard?
Rat Pack.
Rat Pack is one.
Fanny?
Rat Fink!
And Charles?
Charles?
Rat Trap.
Rat Trap. So there they are. are, Darlene. Rat Trap, Rat Fink, and Rat Pack. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one that you may have floating around in your brain.
Rat.
Rat Fink.
Rat Fink. Now, do you really believe that's the right one, the one that's going to be...
Rat Race.
Yeah. Thank you, crowd.
The audience thinks it's going to be Rat Race.
That was my first thought.
What?
Rat Race was my first thought.
Why didn't you say it?
Because Rat Fink sounded so good.
All right. Yes, well, we're looking for a Rat Fink. It's an unusual situation. They're all over the place. But let's find out if there's one under the $100 response. Rat Trap. Okay, that's one answer that was suggested by Charles. Let's see if Rat Fink is under the $250 response. Rat Race. Oh-ho.
Oh, no.
Oh-ho. There may be a Rat Fink around here anyway. I guess that Rat Race sounded good. All right.
Gotta be.
Earl, slide it. Oh-ho. Very good. Very good.
Listen, darling.
You know, the $12,150 is what you've got, and you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Remember what you have to do. You've had a go at it three times. You got to try one more time now. Be still, my fluttering heart. Is that what you're saying? Now, you've got to match one celebrity exactly to collect.
Richard.
Okay, Richard. All right. That's it. Just stand on the adhesive tape. Here we go. $5,000 worth. This will give you $17,150 if it works. Think carefully now. Blank hot. H-O-T. Blank hot. Hot. H-O-T. Blank hot. Richard is ready. Okay. Now, get your ESP going over to Richard Dawson and tell us what answer do you want to come up with that'll match his. Blank hot.
My mind is a blank.
No, I said blank. You have to fill in the blanks.
Red hot.
Red hot? You what?
Just pat. Red hot. Oh, my God.
It just came to you?
Yes.
You mean you were blank?
It just came.
What made you think of it?
I don't know.
Sure, it wasn't a hot flash.
Yeah. No. Richard, she says Red Hot will match you for $5,000. What do you say?
You were absolutely blank, weren't you?
Yes, I was blank.
All the people that doubt that ESP is around.
Does ESP nothing, work?
We just concentrated.
Were you
so
concentrating
hard
on...
And said Red.
We got $17,150. Listen, Darlene, she's getting very close to the all-time high, isn't she? So let's see how she's going to do now as she meets her next challenger. Welcome, Lillian Hargrove. Yay! Welcome to Match Game 76. Please tell us this Lillian Hargrove story.
I'm a nurse's aide. I've got 7 great children, 3 great granddaughters. I took off on bicycle with the 3 youngest 4 years ago to go to the East Coast. We got to Kansas and came back.
What?
We just do things like that.
Now, wait a minute. You rode a bicycle from the West Coast to Kansas?
Well, we had a burglary and were told to come back. So we turned around and came back by bus.
By bus?
Yes.
But how many miles is that from here to Kansas?
I couldn't tell you. All I can tell you is the boys would get 3 miles ahead and wait for little Lillian and I to catch up, and we'd go and come up.
How many miles is it from here to Kansas?
I don't know, but I think we should give her the money just for attempting the bike ride.
That's right.
My granddaughters and I are going to do it this summer.
I'm a bike rider. I think it's an absolutely fantastic sport. It's good for your cardiovascular system. I'm going to give you a complete physical in my dressing room later. But right now, we've got this message for you. We found out during this brief interval here that it's 1,450 miles from here to Kansas, where Lillian Hargrove and her grandchildren bless her. Oh, your children, yeah. It's a marvelous accomplishment. It really is. Now, we've got to stop here, ladies, and we'll put you both in cold storage until we get together next time, and we'll start this game right from the top. Is that all right with you? Splendid! And is there anything I can do for any of you? Have I done all the... have I said good times and City of Angels?
Fannie has a picture.
Fannie has a picture. What is your picture?
It's called Stay Hungry with Jeff Bridges.
Oh, yes.
Should is be that, out.
Any second now.
Any second.
All right. And the Bell of Handlers.
I have a film called Stay Thirsty. Now say goodbye.
Okay. Say goodbye, Gene Rayburn for Match Game 76. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.